If your iMessage isn't syncing properly and you want to know how to fix it, stick around. I got you covered. I'm Dylan Stewart, the MacWhisperer, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to solve iMessage synchronization problems. In most cases, iMessage works amazingly well on your phone, on your iPad, on your computer, keeping your text synchronized and making sure you can receive texts or send texts from any of your devices. But sometimes it just doesn't work right, and this video is going to show you all the steps you need to take to make sure it works perfectly. The first thing we need to do is hop on over to the phone and jump into the Settings app right here. Now let's go all the way to the bottom of Settings and click where it says Apps. From here, we need to get into Messages, which we can do by scrolling or by pressing the little letters on the right side of your screen and jumping right to the M section. Coming into Messages, there's several settings we need to check to make sure things are working properly. The first thing we need to do is scroll down to where it says iMessage. If it's turned off here, that's part of your problem. Go ahead and click that button to turn iMessage on. It may take a moment to activate it. Underneath that, you'll see where it says Send and Receive, and it will usually show a number, an email address, or a certain number of addresses. Let's go ahead and click on that button here. In this section, we should see your phone number and all of the email addresses that are connected to your Apple ID. But if it looks like this instead and it says use your Apple account for iMessage, something's gotten logged out. It's easy to fix it by clicking right here and choosing Sign In. You may be prompted for your Apple ID password, but if it's already saved on the phone, it might enter it in for you. Go ahead and put your password in if you're prompted and click the Sign In button in the upper right-hand corner. Then be patient for a moment because this can sometimes take 30 to 90 seconds depending on your internet connection. Once it signs you in, it should look more like this, with at least your phone number up at the top and any email addresses you have associated with your Apple account. Even if there are accounts that you don't use very often, I strongly recommend making sure they're all checked. Down at the bottom section, you can choose whether you want to start new conversations from one of these email addresses or from your phone number. For almost everyone, using your phone number is recommended. Once you've got these settings set, let's click the back arrow in the upper left-hand corner here. The next thing we need to do is go into iCloud. To do that, click your back arrow on your upper left-hand corner here until you can't anymore, and then scroll up to the top of the page to where your name shows up. Click on your name. Click where it says iCloud, and then in the Save to iCloud section, click where it says See All on the right side here. Once you do that, find Messages. If Messages says Off, like it does for me, click on it and click Use on this phone. That's going to send all of your iMessages up to iCloud, making it even easier for you to synchronize across multiple devices. It's a really helpful tool, and although it will use a little bit of your iCloud storage space, trust me, it's worth it. You can even click the Sync Now button down at the bottom if it doesn't do it automatically, and in a few moments, all of your messages should be located in the cloud. This serves multiple purposes because, first of all, it'll save space on your phone, but second of all, it'll make it even easier to synchronize across all of those different devices. Now your phone's all set up and ready for you. In most cases, when there's a problem with iMessage, it usually has to do with the phone. But in some cases, we may need to change the settings on your other devices as well. So in this case, I'm going to use my computer. If you have an iPad, follow the steps we did for the phone and make sure those same settings are turned on. For the computer, it's a little bit different. As I hop over to my computer here, I'm going to open up the Messages app right from my dock. If you can't find your messages on the dock, you can click on the spotlight right up at the top and just type the word messages and click return. Once you've got your iMessage app open, we'll need to check the settings on it. If you're greeted by this screen, it means you're not signed in properly, and you may need to type in the same Apple ID you used on your phone and sign into it. It'll prompt you for your password again. Go ahead and pop that password in and click sign in and give it a moment for it to synchronize. Once it does, it should open up and it should look similar to the way it does on your phone. But we're not quite done yet. Let's come up to the Messages menu up at the top and let's choose Settings. From here, click over to where it says iMessage and make sure that Messages in iCloud is turned on here as well and that all of your phone numbers and email addresses are checked. If they're not, check any ones that are missing. Once you've done that, your computer will be properly set up and ready for you. But there's one more step to make sure that your iMessages synchronize properly across all of your devices. And this has to do with Android users. So let's hop back over to the phone and back into the Settings app right here. Scroll down to the bottom, go to Apps, click the M, and jump into Messages. Now, as you scroll down here, you're going to see a section that specifically says Text Message Forwarding. Let me explain how this works. When an iMessage user sends you an iMessage, it goes through Apple's server and it automatically synchronizes across any devices that are signed in to that particular Apple ID. But when an Android user sends you a text, it's sent in a different way, either an RCS, an SMS, or an MMS message, and it doesn't automatically go to your devices. So your phone is necessary to forward that text to the other devices. Come down to where it says Text Message Forwarding, and in this section, you should see all of the devices that you've configured using the prior steps in this video, whether it's an iPad, a computer, a second iPhone. Any of these devices that are signed into that same Apple ID need to be turned on. If it says off for any of them, go ahead and click it and turn it on. This will make sure that when an Android user texts you a message, it shows up on your iPad, on your computer, and on your phone. And because you've turned on iCloud synchronization, if you delete a message on one device or forward a message or make changes to it, it will make those changes on all of your devices. Now, I want to give you a small caveat here and say that iMessage is never 100% flawless across all of your devices. Sometimes you'll see an unread message on one device that isn't on another device. But if you follow these steps, you're going to minimize those problems. And occasionally, you may need to read a message on more than one device just to clear it. But in most cases, this will solve everything, making sure that you can always get your messages from your phone, your iPad, your computer, and even your watch. That's what I've got for today's video about how to fix iMessage issues. If you learned something new, give this video a thumbs up to help other people find it. If you've got a question, a comment, something you didn't understand, drop it down in the comments section. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I'm here to make it easier for you to use your Apple products better than ever before. So click that subscribe button and that notify bell so that you always hear about it when I drop new content. And with that being said, we're done with this lesson. But there's always more to learn. Check out this video to learn all about how to use iMessage with iOS 18. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and I'll see you in the comments.